and welcome to my channel. I'm so excited to have you here. So today's video is going to be an MLM horror stories, which you guys already know, so that's pretty much it. I am having today's video be a little bit shorter than normal for MLM horror stories, mostly because Monday's video was so long and it took me so long to edit that I didn't have as much time to make this video super long because I wouldn't have had enough time to edit it. So I hope you guys do not care about that, but what are you guys drinking today? I already had a coffee. So, a water it is, especially because I feel very parched, but let's get into it. So, this one does say trigger warning, eating disorder content, and it's a Herbalife story. So it goes, hi there, have always been a fan of your MLM videos and always thought of sending you my story, but never got around to doing so. I finally decided to, but unfortunately I lost all my receipts from this interaction, but rest assured it's 100% true. Please keep me anonymous. I come from an extremely small country in Southeast Asia, Singapore for anyone who's ever heard of it, and we are not heavily infiltrated by MLMs like America is. In fact, I didn't even know that they had entered our market until this encounter, which led me down the MLM rabbit hole. So I guess that's one good thing that came out of it. Some background first. I've been struggling with depression and anorexia for the longest time, and am actively working on my recovery. On one visit to my psychiatrist's clinic, I bumped into a friend from childhood, and we ended up exchanging Instagram handles. We weren't ever close before, but we chatted over mental health issues, and I learned that she'd been recovering from her ED, but was still struggling with other stuff. Around a week later, she dropped me a message about Herbalife, went on about how it helped her heal her relationship with food, and that I would benefit from it too. I replied, sorry, I'm actually trying to gain weight, and I don't think this would be beneficial. And she actually replied saying how they have plans targeted at weight gain and that it can be tailored to suit my needs. I just replied, no, it's really okay, thanks. And thankfully, she never messaged me again. Ever since then, I've been watching and learning about MLMs, and it's honestly shocking how predatory these sales tactics can be. I'm just grateful I was in a safe space mentally, but I can only imagine how someone who is vulnerable in that moment could take this the wrong way. They may even end up purchasing something just so they could fuel their ED even more. Long story, no receipts, unfortunately, but I'm just glad I could share my story, and hopefully you'll talk about it in your video. Thank you so much for what you do. It really does help shed light on the horrible industry. So thank you so much for sending me your story. I know that it can be really hard in general to talk about things like, you know, mental health, or if you're struggling with something like an eating disorder, it can be really hard to just even say that in an email. So thank you for sending it to me. I also can totally see what you're saying when you said, what is it? Let me get the exact words. You said, I'm grateful that I was in a safe space mentally, but I can only imagine how someone who's vulnerable in that moment could take this the wrong way. And you're exactly right. I feel like a lot of the wellness MLMs don't realize that because they're not taught like actual nutrition stuff. Like they didn't go to school to be a dietitian. They're not sort of personal trainers, so they also don't learn about things like eating disorders and what could really trigger one. And I feel like things like that could, exactly how you responded to this person saying, hey, thanks for the recommendation, but like I'm trying to gain weight, for other people who may not have been in a safe spot mentally could have been affected by that. And that's a huge reason why I really, 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 really dislike MLMs that are fitness related, because they'll go after someone that they think fits the mold of what they're looking for, whether it's based on their looks or their body, and then they will try and get them roped in. I don't know. I don't like them. So I just want to say thank you so much for sending, and to the next one. So this one says, hi Deanna, I'm a fairly new subscriber and I've been loving your content. I'm currently working on my master's degree, and whenever I have free time, I binge anti-MLM content, including all your old videos. This is a short story, but it's something I feel is important to share. My mom has always loved to travel, and one of her dream jobs is to be a travel agent. In the summer of 2019, she decided to try it out as a side job and signed with a company she called Evolution Travel. Through Evolution, she did a bunch of training and then started her own business as a travel agent, booking trips for friends, family, and even people she didn't know. There was a small monthly fee to maintain her license, but otherwise it seemed like a legitimate company. I recently found out, however, that it's an MLM. Due to the pandemic, she decided to stop working for Evolution last summer. No one was traveling anywhere, so the monthly fee was no longer worth it. Fortunately, my mom never got into the recruiting side of the business, and overall, she's made more than she's spent. She still wants to be a travel agent one day, but this experience has made us both more cautious of what organizations we consider working for. I realize this isn't exactly a horror story per se, but I think it's important to people to be more aware of the fact that MLMs are everywhere, and some of them are extremely under the radar. Typically, we think of companies like Monat, LuLaRoe, or Beachbody, but there really are MLMs for everything, even travel agents. So thank you so much for talking about that. And you're right, there are MLMs for travel agencies, for insurance stuff. There's literally Texas MLMs for power companies, like, which I need to do a video on in general, but there's like MLMs for literally everything you can think of. I hope she's able to find like another avenue for travel agency stuff. I don't know the correct terms, but to actually be a travel agent just in a more ethical route and company to work for. Ooh, these have actual screenshots. I'm excited. Okay, it says, hi Deanna, please don't use my name and keep the following Instagram screenshots private. Oh, okay, so she said, yeah, to just blur out the names and faces. I can totally do that. So she said, for background, I hadn't been involved in an MLM, but I really have enjoyed watching your videos. I never really noticed MLMs outside of the Pampered Chef and Mary Kay that you see older women selling until I became a military spouse. Here it is. That demographic is heavily targeted, and I've seen quite a few since we moved to our first base. I live overseas on a military base in Asia. That's cool. There are several things that make life difficult over here. But one thing that I've realized with is finding a hairstylist off base, options are limited, especially with COVID. So I've been using spouses who are hairdressers to get my hair done. Due to PCS cycles, people move in and out frequently, and I've been to 2 to 3 different people during our years here with varying results. I avoid haircuts as long as possible since it's such a pain trying new people. Long story short, I finally found one that does a good job and will be here until we leave. But she has recently jumped into the lovely quote unquote world of Monat. She has leveraged her position as a hair professional to rank up several times and create a large client base. As I know about Monat from your videos, I am back at square one to finding a hairdresser because I'm not about to go to an appointment and one, have their products pushed on me, or two, used on my hair. She also totally drank the Kool-Aid and is fully immersed in their culture. So I don't know how it would go if I brought up why I don't support MLMs. Thankfully, we are moving in a couple months, but it's just sad that some of the few good options for hair care on our base have been infiltrated by MLM. I've attached some screenshots from her Instagram page showing just how great Monat is and how everyone can do it. Thanks for listening to my stories. So let's look at the stories. So one story she posted was, take a minute to Google Bill Gates and the Wall Street Journal opinions on direct selling. They both said if they lost it all and had to start over, they'd find a good network marketing company and get to work. Did you know? No. Did you know that 82% of women making $100,000 per year are doing so through network marketing? It's the new business norm. It's a business in a box. No storefront, no employees, just you and your smartphone. Which, number one, the no employees, you don't end up having a downline because the only way to attempt to even make good money is by building a downline. But that statistic is wrong. Literally, let me see. Hopefully I still have the actual statistic in my phone because CC Suarez actually showed, okay, I can still see it. Okay, I'm screenshotting it so I don't forget it. So the actual statistics, so how she said, did you know that 82% of women making $100,000 per year are doing so through network marketing? That's false. It's kind of like a game of telephone. You know when you tell your friend something and then the friend tells the friend and the friend tells the friend tells the friend tells the friend and everyone thinks or hears something different. That's exactly what this statistic has done. That statistic is wrong. I don't know where they're getting it, or maybe I do. You get it from your upline, and then that upline got it from that one, and it's changed along the way. So the actual statistic is blank percent of people in network marketing who make over six figures a year are women. That's it. It's saying a certain percentage of people in network marketing who make over six figures are women. Not that 82% of women in the United States or the world make their money through network marketing. No, it's not that. It's just saying in network marketing, you know, the bulk of the people that make this amount of money are women, because women are mostly the ones targeted. Not saying that other gender or gender identities aren't targeted, but that's the main group of people that are targeted. So I'll actually share this screenshot. CC Suarez tagged me in an Instagram post and she said, the FTC reports on average 80 to 90% of people in MLMs make a profit of $0. Therefore, how could this girl's post be true? Exactly, it's not. What happened here is a bad game of telephone. The statistic they commonly misquote to fit their narrative is the whole blank percent of people in network marketing who make over six figures a year are women. And then she said, always ask questions, always do your research yourself for credible sources, and for the love of whatever God you believe in, please do not join an MLM. So that's the real statistic. So the next story says, but we're reluctant to try products from brands that our friends and the girl next door love and want to share with you. Why? Because they're trying to make money off of us? Oh, okay, so you're comfortable supporting small businesses. You're comfortable with someone who's trying to pay for college or buy clothes for their kids and making a little profit off of products they love and use themselves. But let's just go give more millions to L'Oreal. Next story. If you're out there preaching support small business, but then block MLM structured businesses, are you really supporting small businesses? This argument in itself is flawed. I feel like this is an MLM fail too. This argument's flawed because yes, I do support small businesses. I love small businesses. I try and shop at them when I can, but your MLM is not a small business. So when they try and relate, oh, I'm an MLM rep, buy my product too, but you support small businesses, right? It's not even something to argue because it's not related to each other. A small business is you, right? You're a CEO, you started your own company, you had your own idea, whatever it may be. Maybe I start selling, I don't know, clothes at a boutique and I'm the one who came up with it and I run everything. I'm the one who ships out the products and does it all. That's a CEO. Someone who is a 1099 independent contractor for another company isn't a business owner. You're an independent contractor that gets a 1099 every single year to file on your taxes in the United States. It's not a small business. You are working for a large corporation, a company that actually has actual workers working in the corporate side of it. So I just don't get where they try and say that MLMs are also small businesses. They're not. You're a large company like Beachbody. Beachbody is a large company. Large. You know how much that Beachbody CEO is worth? The actual CEO? You would be surprised how much he's worth in general.
Editing Deanna here. So even after a quick Google search of looking up how much is Beachbody worth, Forbes.com in 2018 said that Carl Daikeler himself, the CEO, was worth $660 million. And then the company itself in 2017 had a revenue of $1 billion. That clearly is not a small business.
But that's the thing, is anyone who works for Beachbody isn't the CEO. It isn't a small business. You're a salesperson, essentially, for the company, an independent contractor for the company. So no, I can support small businesses and love small businesses and be against the MLM business model and the MLM structure and the way they go about recruitment and the way that you make money, most money in MLMs, the way you rank advance in MLMs. Yes, I can be against that. It has nothing to do with me not liking small businesses. So she also put a question box like, share your thoughts. Those are my thoughts, that your MLM is not even in the same category as small business. And I don't like when they say that. I don't like when they go to things like craft shows where it's is for small businesses that do like homemade things. You're not a small business. Anyways, the next story says, hold and have a read. Oh, and it's the same thing that was on the first stories. It essentially says, take a minute to Google Bill Gates and the Wall Street Journal opinions on direct selling. They said if they lost it all and had to start over, they would find a good network marketing company. And then that whole, did you know that 82% of women making $100,000 per year are doing so through network marketing? It's the new business norm. It's a business in a box. No storefront, no employees, just you and a smartphone. No, it's not. But anyways, going back to the actual MLM horror story, I actually really understand the whole being scared to get your hair done. I have like a horror story as a child with my hair, and it's why I like struggle so much with finding someone to like cut my hair too. I will wait like a year to cut my hair, which I don't like waiting because I, you know, you're supposed to get like trims every 3 to 6 months or whatever, but I'm with you. I would do the same thing, but it does suck that she became like a Monat rep, but I'm happy you're not going to see her because I don't know, she could potentially try and like sell you Monat or put Monat on your hair, which would like not be a good thing. So let's read another one. It says, just Beachbody things, uneducated Huns and their shenanigans. Hey Dee, I've been watching your channel for a while now. I wanted to share my experience with Beachbody. Most of these stories take place when I was in college, fall of 2016 to spring 2019 for context. Oh, here we go again. It says, I also want to put a trigger warning in for I will be talking about ED/disordered eating. My first experience with Beachbody was when I was starting to get into my wellness journey while at school. I didn't really know where to begin, so I turned to Instagram. After finding and following some registered dietitians and personal trainers, Beachbody Huns were all over my For You page. But I thought they were just like the other accounts I followed, i.e. had an education or specialized training on topics such as exercise programs, dieting, etc. So I followed a few, and I clearly remember one of the girls saying, eating is not a fun thing. We eat solely to fuel our bodies to work hard every damn day. Now, I'm not the pickiest eater, but there are some foods I cannot do. Eggs, for example. Being the naive person I was, I took her advice to heart and became orthorexic as a result. I also ate eggs twice a week because I needed to feel to crush my goals, and would order a salad at the local pizza place because I didn't want to fall off the wagon. Another phrase this hun loved to say. I lost about 10 pounds and my period within 1 month. I want to share my story to help others so that they do not have to go through the physical and mental trauma that this caused me. I'm still working on changing my mindset when it comes to food and exercise, but have come a long way. I'm a true believer that now that everyone is beautiful in their own bodies, current diet and body standards can F off. My other story is not as dramatic, but I signed up when the T25 program first came out under a different coach than the one in the above story. And I quit as soon as people in the accountability group started talking about coaching full time and how that should be everyone's goal. I asked what kid of formal training I would need to be a full time coach and was laughed at. I know now the answer is none and all their info comes straight from their asses. I then immediately was on the phone with customer service to get my account canceled. That's also when I connected the dots that the toxic accounts I followed were Beachbody Huns and not certified to say anything about anyone's diet or exercise programs. The other crazy thing was I didn't know what MLMs were until I googled, is Beachbody a scam, after I quit. Thanks, Dee, for everything that you do to raise awareness about these scams. People not only lose money, but can have serious physical and mental side effects as well. I hope this all makes sense. It still can be hard to talk about, and I'm still making steps toward recovery today. So number one, I'm so happy for you, like going to therapy and everything like that, because you did mention it in quotations, and you know, working on recovery, that isn't easy. Recently, this month, I actually did a reaction video to a Beachbody team call. It was so long. In that, I talked so much about this, about when people join MLMs like Beachbody, and literally what that Beachbody upline was saying in that team call reminded me so much of exactly how Beachbody reps and their clients and downlines and whatever, how they can get to the point where they have an ED or disordered eating, or they have guilt when they eat certain foods, or they start binging because they had such a long period of time, or they had to, you know, be super strict with their diet so that they feel bad when they have a piece of pizza or a piece of chocolate. So I know we talked a lot about that in that video, and this is just an example of it. And if you guys don't know exactly what like orthorexia is, let me do the actual definition of what it is so that I don't mess it up at all. But from the healthline.com, it says orthorexia is an eating disorder that involves an unhealthy obsession with eating healthy. Unlike other eating disorders, orthorexia mostly revolves around food quality, not quantity. So essentially with orthorexia, it's where you're so obsessed with your food that it's like all you can eat is healthy, and you become obsessed in an unhealthy manner with having super healthy food. So that makes sense to me. Like after being with Beachbody and dealing with that environment where you are made to feel guilty for having a french fry or a cheeseburger, like happened in this past video where someone said it's bad if you have a couple cheeseburgers in 1 week. Like, that means you've fallen off the wagon, so unhealthy. No, it's not true. So that's what sucks about a lot of Beachbody reps specifically not being actual dietitians, because actual dietitians would teach you, hey, this is how you make a sustainable change in your diet. This is how you make a sustainable lifestyle change based on what your goals are. You know, you can have a goal to just maintain your weight, maintain your body, but want to eat healthier, or maybe you want to lose weight and be in a calorie deficit. A actual dietitian can teach you and help you and walk you through that and be like, this is how you can still fit ice cream in, and you can still fit a cheeseburger in, and you can still fit all these things in and make it a sustainable lifestyle, but then here's how you do it while hitting your goals. So I feel like that's where Beachbody reps, a lot of them don't get it. Like, when I talk about this, I don't feel like a lot of them understand it, because I didn't when I was in Beachbody. I was always taught by my uplines, like, oh, you should be able to train people. You should be able to, you know, have clients and stuff like that. So it becomes this normal thing that you're supposed to have, like, clients and stuff in Beachbody and all of that, when in all actuality, it's not this normal thing. You shouldn't be giving advice and working one-on-one as a coach and giving people nutrition advice one-on-one when you know nothing about it, because then stuff like this happens, or someone is now struggling with a certain disorder because they were put in that environment in the first place. And then also she mentioned signing up again and then doing T25, but then when she went into her accountability group, which is a challenge group, the same thing, it's where Beachbody actually has an app where you log your workouts every day, you log your Shakeology, you log your products you use, and then your upline, or, you know, if you're a rep, your upline, or if you're a client, the actual coach you signed up with will put you in that group, and you will essentially log your workouts daily. They'll give advice, but a lot of the times, challenge groups or accountability groups that Beachbody reps do could be like a hub for recruitment. It's like they're waiting for someone to get a really good, like, body transformation where they can be like, oh my god, you did so good, you want to join as a coach? Like, it is a hub for getting new recruits and getting new coaches to join. So that's always something to keep in mind, because it happens a lot more than, like, I guess you would expect. Like, this person, all she wanted to do, it seems like, is do T25 and then ends up going into the group and having people talk about how your goal should be coaching full time. Like, no, you just want to do some workouts. Like, you just signed up to do T25, like, to do a workout, and you end up trying to push people into doing coaching full time. Not even like, hey, you should join up as a, you know, as a rep and then still work your job. Like, no, they talking about coaching full time. I don't get it. Oh my lord, the shenanigans happening in Beachbody, y'all. But that's going to be all for today. I know it was a lot shorter than normal, but it's just because this week's been a heavy, heavy, heavy editing week on top of getting ready for Monday's deep dive. So that's going to be all in today's video. I hope that you guys liked it. Don't forget to like it and comment down below. I would love to really, really, really know your thoughts on Beachbody's reps and essentially what I talked about, where it's like they're not dietitians, they're training people, and it could have this and this negative impact on somebody. So I would love to know what you guys think, and then don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in the next one.